Hello, my name is Tim Butner. I am a freelance filmmaker. I am not a YouTube gear reviewer, so when it comes to doing this video where I am going to review for you the DZOFilm Vespid Primes, it's because I actually really like these lenses. I can fully endorse them. What I've discovered the last few weeks in shooting with these lenses is they are well-built cinema prime lenses. The construction on them is phenomenal. They're nice and lightweight while also having a small compact design, enough so that when you're flying the lenses on a Steadicam, it feels well balanced. Not only that, you can throw them onto a slider, you can throw them onto a jib, you can throw them onto any kind of system, a gimbal. They are lightweight and compact enough that they are not going to have a major footprint. They are perfect in their size and weight for those purposes. I've discovered characteristics that I really like regarding these lenses. The minimal to zero focus breathing is really nice, and that's in large part because of the 270 degrees of focus throw with the really nice precision that you can get by actually getting the precise focus that you want due to that long throw. The 16 blades in the iris are really nice for creating a gorgeous looking bokeh. It's so well rounded, it looks great, and there's no way in which I could not be more pleased with this other than to say, can more lens companies put more iris blades in? Because this looks gorgeous. When it comes to lens flares, these lenses exhibit a really nice lens flare. It is pleasing, it's not blatantly obvious all the time, which is nice. It's not the J.J. Abrams of in-your-face type of lens flare, which for me is great because I am a filmmaker of a certain type where I like to have a certain amount of bare's multitude in what images I'm creating, especially in regards to, I don't want it blatantly obvious that there's a camera there. With a lens flare, that can actually quickly draw your attention to, hey, there's a camera here. But nonetheless, lens flares can add character, and these lenses have great lens flares. The character of them is so nice and pleasing. Overall, the sharpness of these lenses is one that will make a lot of people happy because they're not clinically sharp. They have a nice rounded sharpness to them, which really helps where they feel classic. They exhibit characteristics of a more vintage lens, but yet in a modern mechanic build. And that to me is really nice. The mechanics are modern, the image is vintage, and that's something that's nice because that's what a lot of people are striving for these days. A lot of people are going out and buying old lenses, modifying them for cinema purposes because we're shooting with digital cameras that are so sharp, and especially a lot of lenses out there are so clinically sharp now that people want to get a softer look. They want to make it feel a little bit more classic. You don't need to do much with these lenses to get that classic feel. They are right there. They're beautiful in how rounded, sharp they are. And that's, to me, wonderful. In conclusion, I am incredibly impressed with these lenses. They are well built. They look gorgeous. I absolutely love the images that I've been getting out of them. And I really want to say that the VIP company of the year is going to be DZOFilm because of what they did with getting these out, with getting the zooms out. And here's the way I'm going to finish this video. Just like a politician will end and say, they approve this message. Well, I am Tim Butner, I am a filmmaker, and I approve these lenses.